So I'm standing here with my date tonight. Hello, Angelina. It's good to see you again.
You ready for Captain America?
I am.
Yeah.
What? Don't sit next to you? Five rows away? Women. Okay, upon the advice of everyone I read on the internet about going to see The Winter Soldier, they said, make sure you get caught up with the first America, Captain America, and the Avengers. I even threw an Iron Man in there just because I was in the mood. I mean, I really marveled it up last night. I'm telling you, it was great. Ooh, look at that. Random Transformer moment. Totally lucked out. Look where the men's room is. And that's my theater. And there's the men's room. And that's my theater. And this is the big drink I'm drinking. Because you know, it's gonna happen right in the middle of the movie. Get my 3D glasses, IMAX, Captain America, the Winter Soldier. Woo! Oh my God, just got done with The Winter Soldier. Holy crap. I have never ever been a fan of Captain America or Black Widow. I didn't even know who the Falcon was. I only, you know, used to focus on Thor, obviously, and Iron Man and Hulk. But holy crap, I look at them in a brand new light. That movie was exciting. I don't know how Marvel does it when they pick their casts the way that they do. First, let me tell you are in for a thrill ride. I don't care what any other reviewers reviewed. As a regular person who's really not that up on canon or the whole storylines of the comics, but that was thrilling. It was fun. I almost feel tired after watching it. I've never been a real super fan of Black Widow, but she has never looked better. Scarlett Johansson just looked, I thought she looked a little chubby in Avengers, and I didn't like her look in Avengers. In this movie, she has the best look she could possibly have. And she was badass. She kicked so much butt, it wasn't funny. The fight scenes and the Falcon, I love the way they joined Captain America and the Falcon together. I like the way the Falcon was. I don't think they could have picked a better casting, a cast for that, this movie. And the Falcon was a perfect pick. And in Captain America, I've never ever been a fan of Captain America. But, man, the fight scenes and everything in the action was just breathtaking. The buildup was really good paced. I don't know what the other reviewers were watching when they said, oh, it was this or it was that. Ha ha. You know, I'm a Marvel fan. I'm not the most dedicated Marvel fan, but I am a Marvel fan moviegoer. And I'm not gonna fangirl on you, but man, that was good. And the storyline, without giving anything away, the storyline has a great assemblage. I mean, they put the story together, you followed the story all the way through, and while watching it, you were just amazed at the way the story went. And it was just, I can't say enough about it. It was just beautiful. It was just absolutely beautiful. One of the things I really, really loved about The Winter Soldier was that everybody seemed comfortable in their skin. Every single character seemed to like what they were doing, seemed to believe that they were the person that they were acting to be, and I don't think there was one bit of overacting or getting used to the role or anything. It just seems like everybody just fit together like a glove, and it was just absolutely stunning to watch. In case I didn't give Sebastian Stan enough credit, I've never seen The Winter Soldier before, so I can't say that he played it to a T, but I like the character that Sebastian Stan played. He doesn't have to have a whole hell of a lot of a dialogue. He just, his looks and the way he looked was just, you know, perfect. Just gorgeous for a villain or a bad guy or whatever the heck he was going to be, the heavy.
but he looked great.
I am going to have to go back and look for the Easter eggs that they planted in the movie. I don't suggest you look for them the first time around, because you don't want to miss any of the movie trying to, you know, scan things. That's always good for a second time, and I will go see it a second time, like, tomorrow, really, if I want to, or Monday. But there are about, I think they said 26 Easter eggs in it to look for, or things that are mentioned that hint to future Marvel movies. And I think you'll clearly see them the second time around than you would with the first. I'm not going to tell you what they are. If you want to Google them, go ahead. But I did Google them. I did look for them. And I saw a lot of them, but I didn't see all of them. And I'm just one of those people that wants to see everything. So I will go back to it again and see them. What did surprise me about the movie is how many people left before the credits rolled. I know, right? Do people not have the internet? Do they not read? There are two scenes after the credits roll. Well, one after the movie ends and then one after the credits roll. Stay for both of them. If you want to know what's going on in the Marvel Universe, stay for both of them. I don't know why those other people left. Maybe they had to pee or something. So I'm going to tell you, if you haven't gone seen the Captain America, the Winter Soldier, you best get on your horse and ride on out here, partner, because that was a kick-ass movie. That said, without giving anything away about the movie, don't miss it. Mighty Thor from somewhere in Orlando, Florida, after seeing the Winter Soldier. See ya!